The search configuration gives you a certain number of options that you can use. If we go into Layout and select Configuration next to Search, we see that all the standard elements that we see in our search window have check marks next to them. We can alter this. You can see the preview window at the bottom. We can alter this by either unchecking items. So if I don't want to see time range, I can uncheck that. If I want to see my filter, I can check that. And all these control what you're going to see on the batch search element in the batch group when it's in the when it's on the display. So you have control all the way from selecting none, which doesn't make a lot of sense, to selecting all, which may make sense. And so you can customize this to whatever format, whatever elements that you want to use in your display. You have control over what results are displayed in your results column in ProcessBook. We've got the results column. You can go under Layout and click Configure next to Results. And on the right are all of the options, all of the configurations that are selected by default. So if for some reason you didn't want to see PI Server, you could remove that, or Procedure, you could remove that. And you're left with Batch ID, Visible Anchored, Start Time, End Time, Product, and Unit Name. So you're controlling the what columns you're seeing in your batch display. You can also show data columns. So if you wanted to see a tag or an alias or an expression or anything like that, you could add those to the element as well. So there's also a preview window down at the bottom that you can see how it's going to look. So you have complete control over the results panel as it's displayed on your batch group. To configure your Gantt charts, you simply open up your batch definition and select Configure next to Gantt, and you have control over everything from the title down to the color of all of the sections. You can choose what to display, whether you're going to display the title or whether you're going to display the grids. And you can control whether you want people to align when they're zooming in on trends. We'll see that a little bit later. And which labels you want to show them. So if you want to show the PI batch label, you can show that. If you uncheck that, then your labels, your batch level will be blank. You also have control over the unit and sub-batch level and what you want to show there. Now, by default, we're going to show the ID numbers and the names of the sub-batch, but you can show anything you want. You can show product name for the unit batch. You can show the procedure. So there's lots of different options you have on your Gantt chart on what to show. You don't have to necessarily show ID number all the time. Also, there's a legend here that we want to show you for the Gantt chart. You can tell what level you're evaluating by looking at the hash marks in the upper right-hand corner of each Gantt bar. If it's got four lines, you're looking at the PI batch level. Three hash marks indicate unit batch level. Two hash marks indicate the highest sub-batch level. And then one and none indicate the second and subsequent levels of the sub-batch in the Gantt chart. If you're familiar with ProcessBook, then using the BatchView add-in will be very easy. You simply select the batch icon in the toolbar or batch group from the draw menu, draw a large area on your screen, and the configuration window will appear. It's very similar to the way that trends are drawn. I'll make sure I'm in build mode. I'll select draw batch group, and I'll draw a large box on my screen to place my batch group. And I get the batch definition window. Now, remember that when you're in run mode or build mode, the ProcessBook will behave a little bit differently. If you want to make changes to your batch group that are permanent, make sure that you're in build mode and make sure that you save. So in the main window, we have a main tab, a layout tab, and a settings tab. And the main tab has the same search criteria that we saw in our BatchView quick search. I'm going to use my example that we used earlier. I'm going to search for all of my unit batches on my server that were active in the last 4 hours for my digester number one. So I'll click search. And you can see that I've got four results here. And the bottom of the screen, the available aliases, lit up for me. And you can see that I have a pressure and a temperature alias available in this part of this unit batch. Now, I want to see my temperature aliases, so I will click Add Alias, and that will add it to the particular selected tag aliases section here. Now, you want to make sure you visit the Layout tab before you continue, because, as you will see, in the Layout tab, only the Gantt chart is selected. You will not get a search or results panel unless you select those in the Layout tab. You will, however, get a trend for every alias you selected on the earlier panel. As long as I select all four, I will get all four of the batch group sections here. You can see they light up as I mouse over them. And if I wanted to configure any one of them in a special configuration way, I could click any of the configuration buttons to do that as well. Also, in the Settings tab, you can set things like how the start times are displayed, your plot labels, your start times, your end times, start as batch start, end as batch end, things like that. You can set the color schemes. There's different color schemes that you can use. And you can choose when things are updated. We'll see custom name sets a little bit later. So once I get all my selections built, I can click OK. And what I'll get on the screen is a batch group that will be drawn with my batch search in the upper left, my results in the lower left, my Gantt chart, and my temperature trend off to the right.